Hey, good evening, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. My name is Nurul Huda bint Abdul Jabbar from Malaysia. I would like to present my research on chemical enhancement for latent shuprin at crime scene. So for introduction part, footwear creates marks at the crime scenes called as shuprin and can be extremely informative for the forensic investigators. For example, it can be used to identify or eliminate any footwears in investigation or link the crime scenes to different crime scenes, identify the number of perpetrators and find the foot size of the persons present at the crime scene and so much. So the sole of the footwear picks up various kinds of materials as a person walk, okay. Usually, this is the way how a person will enter any premises. So when they walk, the footwear that it tends to pick up the materials where they step on, and this is readily transferred to other surfaces, creating an impression that can reveal the pattern of the shoe sole. So there are a few types of impression that can be found. For example, it could be a plastic impression like 3D, visible impression, or invisible. So the one that invisible, known as latent shuprin, and usually it is harder to be detected by the naked eyes, or sometimes it is partially visible, and most of the time it is being overlooked. Moreover, most of the were formed on static, couldn't bring the evidence to the lab for further investigation. So hence, a means of enhancing the shoe print must be undertaken. Bloodstained shoe print or muddy shoe print recovered at the crime scene could be enhanced using chemical reagents specific for the detection of blood or mud attached to the shoe prints. So the method and methodology, in this research, I have used six different matrices with different natures. For example, porous and non-porous, light colors or dark colors, okay? And then for the second one, the shoe print preparation, as I mentioned earlier, I have selected two different types of shoe prints. One is blood stain, another one is mud stain. So for the mud stain, I have collected the mud from different locations, add with water, make it slurry, and then leave it for some time so that the water will descend off. And then the resulting muddy surface were used to form the latent shoe print. Whereas for blood stain, the blood was obtained from hospital. It was a screen blank expired blood. Then the blood was poured in a plastic basin. The latent shoe print were generated by putting on a pair of patterned sole shoes and then stepping on a specific stain area for 5 seconds. The stained shoe was stepped on a plastic sheet several times before stepping on the matrices to reduce the amount of blood attached to the shoe sole. And then after that, we have to prepare the, of course, we have to prepare the chemical reagent in advance. The prepared chemicals were poured in a spray bottle and it is, the reagent was sprayed onto the matrices containing the shoe print, the latent shoe print. And then we leave the dye solution to dry approximately for 1 minute. After that, rinse it with distilled water to remove excess of dyes. Once the matrix dry up, take a photograph of the enhanced shoe print. And also, the photograph was taken with a scale, of course, to measure the length, width, and patterns of the shoe sole is recorded. And as you can see in the results side, I have presented two reagents for bloodstained shoe print and two reagents for mud stained shoe print. In this study, actually, I have investigated 9 reagents for blood stain and then 9 reagents for mud stained shoe print. Okay, the one I have presented in the table is the best outcome only. So for blood stain enhanced shoe print, leukomyelocyte green and patent blue give the best results or enhancement. And then for muddy shoe print, potassium ferrocyanide and Sudan black gave the best enhancement. So in this results table, I have used three indicators. Number one is good, then fair, third one is poor. Good means a shoe print was enhanced fully by the chemicals. The pattern and the dimension of the shoe print could be observed clearly. For fair, the dimension of the shoe print was seen clearly. That means the length and the width, and the pattern is not clear, or vice versa. Only the partial shoe print is developed clearly. And for poor, both the pattern and the dimension is not clear, or you can say there is not much different before and after enhancement. So looking at the results, glucomalaside green is very effective on most of the matrices. And also pattern blue. Potassium ferrocyanide, also effective on most of the surfaces. And Sudan black is it gives a poor enhancement on porous foot wrapper and also tiles. Okay, so basically, these chemical reagents, it reacts with certain molecules in the blood or in mud. For example, leukomyelocyte green, it reacts with the peroxidase in the blood. Okay, so due to the oxidation process, it gives a bright green color of enhanced shoe print. And it is also organic-based solution or organic-based reagent. Whereas for pattern blue, it is a water-based reagent. It reacts with the protein in the blood stain. For ferrocyanide, potassium ferrocyanide, the ferric salt reacts with the pigments in the organic compounds in the mud to give Prussian blue color. So you can see in the figure there, enhanced shoe print is in blue color. And also for Sudan black, it reacts with the fat in the mud to give a black color. So as a conclusion, out of the 18 reagent tested, only these four reagents have seemed to be very effectively enhancing the latent shoe print. So we can use this reagent to prepare a reagent toolkits for the crime scene investigating team. They can bring the toolkit to the crime scene for enhancing the latent shoe print, where they cannot bring the evidence to the lab for further investigation. So yeah, it could be a suggestion that you can prepare the reagent on your own at the lab, okay, before you go to the crime scene, okay, rather than you have to purchase, it could be expensive and all that. So with that, thank you.